When the nasal cavity becomes obstructed, the child will have a symptom of constant cold. That means most parents will observe that their child is having a constant running nose. Constantly child has to keep blowing, clearing or wiping off nasal secretion. Child will have difficulty in breathing, especially at night. When the child tends to sleep and the nasal cavity gets blocked from the back and child is not able to take a breath through the nose, automatically the mouth will tend to open. So these children, parents would have observed that the children tend to have mouth breathing at night. They take a very long time to eat and complete their meals. Basically because the child will have to breathe through the mouth as well as swallow through the mouth. And that can be a very difficult task for a very small child of say age 3 or 4 to be able to do it conveniently. I'm Dr. Sreenivas Murthy TM. Tonsils and adenoids are lymphoid tissues which are placed at the entrance of our aerodigestive tract. That means at the back of the nose and at the back of the oral cavity or the entrance of the throat, we have lymphoid tissues which are arranged in a circular form. They are also called as Waldayer's ring, and these are part of the entire lymphatic system in the body, which acts as a first line of defense against bacteria and viruses which can enter the body through either air, food or water. Now, tonsils and adenoids are graded clinically. That means when a doctor examines someone's oral cavity or the back of the nose, we will see the size of the tonsils now and the adenoids, which can be graded as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now, every human being born has tonsils, and every child by the age of 6 months of age will have appearance of adenoids. Now, these adenoids are tissues which can be in most human beings till the age of around 12 to 13, beyond which they make a disappearance. So, the adenoids are seen only in basically in the childhood and early adolescence. Now, if they are in the grade of 1 and 2, we consider it as normal because this particular size of adenoids do not cause any particular obstructive symptoms. Similarly, tonsils too will not cause any major obstructive symptoms when they are of grade 1 and 2. Whereas when either the tonsil or the adenoids or both the adenoids and tonsils are of grade 3 and 4, which means they are so big that they occupy nearly 75% to 80% of the cavity around which they are placed, it can cause obstructive symptoms. Now, when we say obstructive symptoms, patient will have difficulty in breathing, difficulty while swallowing food, and over and above that, if the child gets an infection, the size becomes even more bigger, causing more distress to the child. Now, child can have only adenoid enlargement, or it can have only tonsil enlargement, or a combination of both. Let us see what happens when a child has only adenoid enlargement. When the adenoids enlarge in size, they tend to block off the nasal cavity from the back. That means at the back of the nose, it acts like a physical obstruction, like a dam. Now, when it is grade 3, grade 4, you are looking at a nasal cavity which is near totally obstructed. So, when the nasal cavity becomes obstructed, the child will have a symptom of constant cold. That means most parents will observe that their child is having a constant running nose. Constantly, child has to keep blowing, clearing or wiping off nasal secretion. Child will have difficulty in breathing, especially at night. When the child tends to sleep and the nasal cavity gets blocked from the back and child is not able to take a breath through the nose, automatically the mouth will tend to open. So these children, parents would have observed that the children tend to have mouth breathing at night. They take a very long time to eat and complete their meals, basically because the child will have to breathe through the mouth as well as swallow through the mouth. And that can be a very difficult task for a very small child of say age 3 or 4 to be able to do it conveniently. The children who have near total blockage tend to also have very noisy breathing at night, something very similar to what an adult would have, like snoring. Now, when this enlarged adenoids tend to get infected, that means virus has entered or a bacteria has entered and then cause an enlargement and swelling, it can tend to cause excessive mucus secretion, which can then go and stand at the end of the nasal cavity. When the child tends to sleep, This can slip down into the throat and then it will cause phlegm accumulation in the throat, and this phlegm is very, very gooey like gum. So a child of the age that we are talking about will still not have the coordination to be able to swallow it or clear the throat and spit it out. So these children tend to end up having vomiting episodes. They tend to vomit all the food that they have consumed because of this gooey material getting stuck in the throat. Another important organ which is very close to the adenoids is called the eustachian tube. Now the eustachian tube is a ventilatory tube which connects the ear with the back of the nose. When we say it is a ventilation tube, basically it allows air from the nose to enter the ear so that middle ear aeration can be achieved, so that your hearing is normal. Whereas people or children who tend to have huge adenoids getting recurrent infections can have eustachian tubal blockages secondary to the enlargement and infection, causing middle ear infection. That means child can have decreased hearing, can have repeated ear pain. An occasional child can even have discharge coming out of the ear, like some blood can come out, watery material can come out, sometimes pus can come out. So these are the effects of enlarged adenoids on the ear. Now, a constant mouth breathing can also lead to a child mid-face not growing as well as it should grow. So this can lead to dental problems as well as jaw malformations. That means the lower jaw tends to become protruded, the teeth tend to become protruded, it comes forwards, the dentition will become overcrowded, that means one teeth will start growing on another teeth, and the jaw takes a very peculiar angle, and it's called development of adenoid facies. Now this will again require orthodontic work, dental procedures later on in life to correct the alignment as well as render the patient in such a way that the mouth is not constantly kept open. As we have already discussed previously, tonsils and adenoids are normal organs which are there in every human being. So does a normal organ need to be removed? It need not be removed as so long as it doesn't give problems. But do these organs give problems by themselves? See, by nature, since they are lymphoid tissues, they will be prone to get infected more than other organs in the body. Now, in today's world, removal of adenoids and tonsils are largely limited to those children who will have obstructive symptoms. That means if the tonsils and adenoids have become infected so often, have become swollen so often for a long duration, such that they are causing obstructive symptoms. Now, what are obstructive symptoms? Difficulty to breathe through the nose, snoring, mouth breathing, an effect causing repeated infection in the ear, and a tonsil size which is more than 3 or nearing 4 causing difficulty in feeding habits. These are the indications for removing the tonsils if they are not responding to medication.